Hey everyone, today I have some consumer advice for those of you getting into recording. Here are some free DAWs or free digital audio workstations that you can download right now and start recording. So here we go. Alright, so my first piece of software that I would recommend is GarageBand. GarageBand is free if you're a Mac user. If you have an iPhone, if you have an iPad, if it's on your laptop, it's pretty easy to fire up and get into it right away. The learning curve is very, very little. It's a loop-based sequencer, so you can start dropping in loops and start making stuff right off the top. It has smart instruments, so you could sit there and instead of programming a drum machine, you can go on a pad and say, I want like loud and busy, and it'll generate a drum groove, and there's different like drummers you can go through, which is a lot of fun. They do that with keyboards, and they have a ton of loops and effects that you can mess around with, right? Which is really, really nice. Some of the downfalls with GarageBand is you don't have a lot of editing features. So, you know, if you want to do like fine fit, like crossfades and stuff like that, you're limited to 8-track recording. Again, I don't know if this is a con because if you're not doing drums, who cares? 24-bit, you don't get that. You only get 16-bit. And you can only have 2 effects per track. So if you like to do big mixing with a ton of effects, GarageBand's probably not gonna do it. But if you're just starting out, it's a fun way to kind of start making music and doing that. I've used GarageBand quite a bit actually when I'm demoing. So if I have an idea in my head and I just wanna come up with some kind of harmony progression and a groove, I'll fire up GarageBand, make something, import in Pro Tools, and then I'll keep going. So that's the first DAW I'd recommend. The second one I recommend is Pro Tools First. So back a couple years ago, Pro Tools introduced Pro Tools 12, and with that launch, they introduced Pro Tools First. So it has its limitations, but it's a great piece of software for the person that knows they want to learn more about Pro Tools and they want to get more professional in their recording. This kind of lets you get your hands dirty with Pro Tools. So like all the editing functions that you would have in Pro Tools are there. You can do like all the smart tool stuff, all the fine crossfading, grid. You don't get things like Beat Detective. You can only record up to 16 tracks. I think 16 tracks, that'd be like 8 stereo, 16 mono, and that's including, and then MIDI tracks as well on top of that. So if you have big mixes, again, you're gonna be limited. There's no video support. So if you're learning Pro Tools for video and you wanna practice, you're not gonna use Pro Tools First. And also one of the things that I didn't like about Pro Tools First was you only get three projects. So if you're working on 3 songs and you need to do a 4th song, you got to get rid of one of your songs. You can work on tracks offline, but they got to sync with your session eventually. So those are some cons with Pro Tools First, but still great piece of software. It's a lot of fun. I recommend it if Pro Tools is a direction that you're going in. Pick up this one and start messing around with it because it's only going to give you more experience using Pro Tools. The third piece of software that I recommend is Reaper. So Reaper right off the bat, okay, it's not really free, it's $60, but here's the thing with Reaper. It gives you a free trial and it's 60 days, and then after those 60 days, it will pop up a message saying, do you want to buy Reaper? And you just say no, and you just keep using Reaper for free. I would recommend that you would buy Reaper. If it's something you like, pay for it. For the free version, you get a limitless track count. So, you know, if you want to use 30, 40 tracks, you get to use 30, 40 tracks. It's PC and Mac compatible. You have like VCA editing. There's a ton of plugins. It uses VST plugins, which is a file. It's a format for plugins. And it's freeware, so there's tons of them out there. And there's tons of free VST plugins out there. So you can really build up a really sweet bank of plugins right off the get-go for your studio. It has a lot of great routing features. I worked with an engineer that he did film just using Reaper. He swore by Reaper. And he was able to do some really great routing and some really, really neat things with it. Some of the downfalls with Reaper, there's not that many. It's not the nicest looking piece of software to look at. And there's quite a bit of a learning curve off the top. So if you're just getting into it, you might find it a little frustrating at first because, you know, it's pretty comparable to like Pro Tools and Logic. Those are my recommendations for free digital audio workstations. I hope you liked my video. Please like and subscribe and share with your friends. Check me out on Twitter and Instagram, and I have a website. I'll leave all the links down below, and leave comments. If I'm missing any digital audio workstations that you would say, oh, this one's way better, you should have talked about this one, let me know, because there's a lot that I haven't tried out yet that I want to try out. So yeah, let's get the discussion going on some DAWs, and I will see you guys soon. Cheers.